just saw. Samoa Joe cannot be in a good mood. Beth, who could blame him? No good thoughts in the mind of Samoa Joe.
Yeah, Joe's looking like a volcano about to erupt, rightfully so, after Cross snapped last week and choked him out. I think it's safe to say Joe has some bad intentions in his soul.
Tick tock, tick tock. Guess who's come to smash your clock? Joe! This is not what I wanted, and it's certainly not what I had in mind. When me and you agreed that you would come back here to NXT, you knew exactly what I had in mind. You cannot be calling out superstars. That is not your position.
No, incorrect. Incorrect, Regal. I can, because the agreement was if I was provoked, you can consider me provoked, and I'm here to mete out the consequences.
I understand. But last week, you entered the ring in a referee capacity. Cross put his hands on Samoa Joe, the referee, not Samoa Joe, NXT management.
Semantics. Semantics. You, of all people, are to come out and explain to me the ridiculousness of semantics. Let me explain something to you. Cross is out of control. Cross needs to be put down. You have no control over him. Did you know about his little field trip to Raw last week? You don't. Because you don't control the man, and you know it. And I am here to put him under control.
Joe, just so we understand each other, Cross is on his way here. And when he gets here, all hell will not break loose, and you will solve this problem peacefully. Do we understand each other? Don't say another word unless it's the right one.
Because of my deeply held respect for you, I can guarantee that tonight will be the end of this. But I can't guarantee it'll end peacefully. And I can guarantee you somebody tonight is going to sleep.
Myself, Samoa Joe has a tremendous amount of respect for Mr. Regal, but with that being said, he is a raging bull right now, and he is ready to explode.